Who knows what that's called?
If you handle it with care and don't touch the pegs, Dallas, for your fiddle, I'll just check the tuning, please. Thank you.
Kole Crook was a young man from Hay River, and he absolutely loved to fiddle. And when he played with his whole being, and people just were so enthused. He created so much for different events where he would perform and people would be dancing. Fiddle has a global and a local significance in our traditions. In the Northwest Territories, there are a number of traditional fiddlers that took their fiddle with them on the trap line and down the river cobbled together whatever they could to keep the fiddle playing, and it's part of the tradition. And I think that speaks to our young people. And I do find that students in the Northwest Territories have a particular aptitude for fiddling. They can play by ear very readily, and the tunes just stay in their mind. They remember so many tunes.
Try it with me. Open, two, one, D, three, open. Open, yeah, and that's the hardest part of the song. I think for students in the North, fiddling can be really important because for many of them there's a cultural and historical tie that the fiddle was the instrument of the voyageurs, it fit in the canoe, and many of them have aunts, uncles, grandparents who have fiddled, or somebody in their family or a close friend fiddled. So very often, I know when teachers, when Gordon and Helen went into Trout Lake one time, Gordon spent a lot of time repairing old fiddles that he said just came out of closets and everywhere. So it is an instrument that's been big in the North, and it often gives kids the connection with their families or with the previous generation.
We live in such a huge country that because we're so spread out and far apart, and particularly up here in the North, we don't always get an opportunity to experience and hear different styles of music. So when we get instructors to come up here from different parts of Canada, it makes the country a little bit smaller.
And make sure you watch then, because that as soon as we do that little tremolo thing, as soon as our bows, JJ and my bow, come off the string, everybody needs to come off at the same time, or you're going to be the last person playing by yourself, which you don't want.
I've seen the program grow in the last 9 years in an incredible way. It started with keen students for sure, but a smaller group, probably a group of about maybe between 15 and 20 students in just a couple of communities. And now the Kole Crook Fiddle Association services about 13 or 14 communities, and we've had camps from with students from across the Northwest Territories with upwards of 100 to 150 students attending. So it's been a really positive growth over the years, and a quick growth as well. It's brought so many students that otherwise might not come to school might be at school but not be a part of, you know, something that includes them with their peer group. And just the amount of learning that's going on beyond the things that that already happen in the classroom. So it's just for so many reasons, and most of all, I think for self-confidence, is just really, it's just been such a positive thing for students in the North. And I get feedback every single time I teach. I get feedback about that from students, not necessarily verbal, but just from watching their faces, from seeing them come to things outside of school time on their own time, from seeing them come back from Christmas holidays with their own fiddle because they've talked their parents into buying them one, and you know, stuff like that. So so it's just such a great thing to promote, and so many success stories coming out of it.
It's been quite a journey, tremendous growth. We started out when Kole Crook passed away. About 6 months after that, the organization formed to keep fiddle music alive in the North. I've seen it grow from a very small organization, 20 students or so, meeting about once every 6 months, to a program that now we have January Jamborees, one big summer camp, and we have four tours in different communities throughout the year. So we get together about six times, but we also have local programs happening every week in the communities.
For a program to be successful, this continuity of programming is essential, and I think what is unique and maybe not a positive aspect of teaching in the North, teachers in the North, is that they tend to be a transient group of people that come through. They have great opportunities and really good ideas for kids, but aren't necessarily in for the long run. So a kid will learn how to speed skate really well for 2 years when that specialist is there, and then they leave, and then that skill kind of drops off. So kids are used to that. So you go to communities, and often if it's the first time in a community, you're sometimes approached with a little bit of apprehension because you can see that the thinking is, well, here comes another activity that will last for however long, and then we'll all buy our fiddles, and then they won't come anymore to help us, you know? So the consistency of the programming is essential. And for example, in the community that I'm teaching in on a regular basis, I've been coming here every Monday for the past 4 years, and now there's more buy-in because the community believes the program will continue. They've seen proof of that, and they know that they're investing in something valuable for their kids. And the kids come because they know that it's something that is being sustained and is being supported and appreciated.
Additional funding or support could be really important for the program because it could enable getting teachers up here more often. It could also provide more fiddles for students. In some communities, there are a limited number of fiddles, so students are sharing fiddles. And we really see tremendous growth in the kids once they're able to take their fiddle home and practice outside of that 1 hour a week or the 2 days a week that they get together. Funding could also help us make technology and those teaching tools more accessible to students by ensuring that there are iPads loaded with the music or the programs, the lessons that could help students learn when the teachers aren't available. And it would be nice if schools had a couple of those each that could be dedicated to the Fiddle Association and the teaching tools there.
Next one would be cabbages.
Yay!
Oh, sounds like we all know cabbages.
My favorite song.
Thank you.
So with more resources, we could actually take the teachers that we have, hire more teachers, and be able to access these communities, and not only access the communities that we haven't been able to go into very much, but also to go more consistently into the communities that we do go to. So I think that's the key to having this program just continue to grow as it has been and keep the fire going, as they say.
The fiddling is such a huge part of our culture and what makes our country, that sometimes gets lost nowadays with the big melting pot that is pop music. And I really hope we don't lose that part of our heritage, because if that goes, we all might as well just wear the same clothes and wear the same hat and wear the same sunglasses.
It would also be nice to have more funding to enable some of the students to travel to the jamborees and camps. Travel in the north is really expensive, as is accommodation. So for students from some of the isolated communities to be able to get to the weekend jamboree or to the week-long summer camp and have that experience of playing with a lot of other people and having that intensive professional instruction. And they need funding for that. It's just not available through the individuals or their families or sometimes even local businesses.
Everybody knows everybody in the north. And coming from a big city, you wonder, now everybody just knows me. I had better learn everybody else too, to become part of, you build a history together in the north. And that history reaches way back, and that ties into fiddling as well. I see communities working together. When we get together for a jamboree, we have students and chaperones coming from 8, 9, 12 communities at a time, and their students play, learn tunes from each other. So they're growing together. They're developing a northern identity. They're developing in their social skills, their social awareness.
I want to do good in this community, and I want to show the community what I'm really made of. And I have been doing a lot of great things, and fiddle is one of them.
Well, I said, who knows? If I knew, I would say it. Right?